There could be anything in there.
This is the biggest bag of air I've ever seen in my life. What do you think, Alice? What do you think?
These are the Sparco Sprint series of seats, which are some of the cheapest FIA certified seats that you can buy on the market today. Now you might be wondering why I'm already replacing the Sparco R100 that I put into the Porsche. Well, two reasons. One, the R100 seats are currently on back order. I ordered the passenger seat back at the beginning of March. It is currently the end of May and I still don't have that seat. About a week ago, I received a notification that it would be out for delivery by the end of July. And I did not want to wait that long. I wanted a passenger seat, so I decided to buy something that was available and in stock. The second reason is that the R100 seats actually sit a bit higher than originally anticipated. As you know, in my video, I installed the R100 seat with seat sliders. And well, after trying to drive with that, I realized that I couldn't even see the gauges because I was sitting so high that the top of the steering wheel cut off on the gauges, which is really weird because overall the seat dimensions are about the same as these, but that lower cushion is just elevated so much higher. While I think those seats would probably be great in a typical sedan or coupe or any sort of vehicle that you might be building, if you're trying to fit them into a smaller car like a Boxster or a Miata or an MR2, depending on how tall you are, you might not be happy with the finished result. This is the standard Sprint, and this is the Sprint L. You might notice that the L is all around larger and sits higher than the regular seat, but this isn't going to be a problem because this seat is going in the passenger side of the vehicle and is going to be fixed to the floor. This seat is going on the driver's side of the vehicle and will be on sliders, which will raise it up to be about the same height as this one once installed in the car. Initial impression about these seats, they are very comfortable. I've been a huge fan of Sparco seats for many years, and these do not disappoint. I actually really like that the shoulder bolsters and the lower cushion have this rubbery texture to really help keep you planted in your seat. Another great feature of these seats are the fact that they have both side mount and lower mounting points for using either a bottom mount or side mounts in a car. Another nice thing about these seats are the fact that they have holes in the bottom here for 5 and 6 point harnesses. And also for my intended application being the Boxster, the seats are mounted to the floor. So you don't want the front cushion of the seat to be straight. You actually want it to sit upwards a little bit and have some bolstering underneath your legs, which these seats have, and it's really great. It's comfortable and it helps keep you in position. So without further ado, I'm going to take the R100 out of the Porsche. I'm going to put both of these Sprints into that car. I already have a video showing how to remove the seats in this car. If you want to see it, click the link above or in the description below, and we'll just cue the music and go from there. These seats definitely sit a lot lower in the car, as you can tell. Here's the R100, and here is the Sprint. Now, I promise, this is probably going to be one of the last videos that you see with the Porsche for a little while. Just because I have a lot of Volvo projects that I want to finish up. I actually have a lot of Volvo videos that I just need to finish editing and upload, so I'll get those posted to my channel soon. Be sure to subscribe and check those out. If you like this video, give it a like, and I don't know, follow me on Instagram.